Warning, some of the reagents shown in this video are harmful. Although the preparation and use of the chemical solutions shown in this video is not difficult, experience in the safe handling of chemicals is required. Read the material safety datasheet of every reagent and work in a fume hood. Process 01 is an open source two-layer PCB process that I have been developing since 2017. In this second video, we will detail the preparation procedure for all the solutions used in the process. The plating solutions presented in this video are adapted from the 2013 and 2014 Universal Metal Finishing Guidebook, which provided key insights on the chemistry behind metal plating. Process 01 combines this and other sources of information with many experiments and fine-tuning until all the steps could be stringed together, making a working PCB. To replicate process 01, you will need 15 starting chemicals: concentrated sulfuric acid, 34% hydrochloric acid, sodium hydroxide, acetone, copper chloride PCB etchant, sodium chloride, copper sulfate pentahydrate, potassium carbonate, or, as an alternative, sodium carbonate but not sodium bicarbonate, hydrogen peroxide in 3% or above concentration, stannous chloride dihydrate, palladium chloride, Triton X100, 37% formaldehyde, disodium EDTA, and polyethylene glycol. Process 01 has 9 steps requiring chemicals, excluding the simple water rinses. The first is step 4, or the PCB cleaning step. This step requires dilute sulfuric acid, with a concentration around 10% by weight. You can prepare this solution by dissolving 13 ml of concentrated sulfuric acid in 225 ml of deionized water. This solution is stable and can be stored indefinitely and reused multiple times. Step 6 requires the palladium chloride activator. Unfortunately, I do not have the video for the preparation of this solution, but the formula is as follows. Start with 40 ml of deionized water in a beaker. Add 20 mg of palladium chloride. Then add 2.25 g of stannous chloride dihydrate. Then add 7.75 g of sodium chloride. Add 2.5 ml of 34% hydrochloric acid. And finally, add deionized water till a total volume of 50 ml is reached. Remember to stir the solution after each addition. This solution should be stored in a well-closed container. It should last several months to 1 year and can be reused multiple times. Step 7 is the post-activator. It can be prepared by adding 182 ml of deionized water to a beaker, after which 18 ml of 34% hydrochloric acid is added, followed by 4 g of tin chloride dihydrate. I did not have much luck in reusing this solution. It appears to oxidize in a few weeks. Step 9 is the electroless copper bath. To prepare it, start with adding 2.52 g of copper sulfate pentahydrate to a beaker, followed by around 150 ml of deionized water. Stir until all copper sulfate is dissolved. Once this is done, add 5.8 g of disodium EDTA. Stir for a while, but this will not dissolve completely. Add around 2 g of sodium hydroxide and stir. Now the EDTA will fully dissolve. Next, add 4 drops of Triton X100, a surfactant used as brightener to improve the quality of the plating. Finally, add 1.6 ml of 37% formaldehyde. You should prepare this solution when you are ready to make a PCB, as the formaldehyde decomposes via the Cannizzaro reaction in alkaline conditions. After use, this solution can be stored, but it needs to be acidified with concentrated sulfuric acid, bringing it to a strongly acidic pH. In this condition, it should last around 1 year. In a well-closed container, to prevent the escape of volatile formaldehyde. When reusing it, sodium hydroxide needs to be added to bring the pH again in the strongly basic region. If, after being in storage, the pH is no longer acidic, it has gone bad and needs to be discarded, but it may happen that after prolonged storage it does not work anyway. In this case, try adding more formaldehyde before giving up. Step 11 is the electrolytic copper plating step. This bath can be prepared as follows. Start by pouring 150 ml of deionized water to a beaker. To it, add 12 grams, around 6.5 ml, of concentrated sulfuric acid. Then, add 40 grams of copper sulfate pentahydrate. Stir until it is fully dissolved. Then, add 0.2 grams of polyethylene glycol used as brightener. This can be bought either in solid or liquid form. Both will work. Then, add 2 drops of copper chloride PCB etchant, as trace amount of chloride ions improve the plating quality. Finally, adjust the volume with the ionized water till 200 ml. This solution is stable in storage and can be reused multiple times. Step 19 and 29 require a negative photoresist developer that can be made from 3 grams of potassium carbonate in 100 ml of regular tap water. This solution cannot be reused. Step 22 uses the copper chloride PCB etchant. Instructions for making this are given by NurdRage in the video linked in the description. This solution is stable and can be reused indefinitely, provided hydrogen peroxide is added at every use, and hydrochloric acid is replenished from time to time. Step 24 uses a concentrated sodium hydroxide solution to strip the photoresist. It is best prepared immediately before use by dissolving 2 spoons of sodium hydroxide in 100 ml of water. Be careful, it heats up a lot. This solution cannot be reused. Finally, here is a reagents table showing which reagents are used to prepare the required solutions. To conclude this video, I would like to add some remarks. Although process 01 works, I consider it just the beginning. That's why I called it 01, as I expect it to be followed by an improved process 02 and so on. Among possible improvements, here are some that I find interesting. YouTube user GUser210 experimented with 2 mercaptobenzothiazole to improve the speed of electroless copper plating. If this plating turns out to be fast enough, it could be possible to skip the electrolytic plating steps entirely, reducing the process complexity. Applied science showed a process that sidesteps the need for protecting the copper from the etching bath by not requiring etching. While it requires a laser cutter and is not compatible with standard copper-clad boards, it may lead to the development of 3D-printed circuits with arbitrary shapes. NurdRage is experimented with silver and copper conductive inks, possibly leading to a different process that would not require toxic formaldehyde and palladium salts, being thus suitable for amateurs without experience in handling dangerous chemicals.